Good morning, students. Today we are going to start with the second chapter, Egyptian civilization. This civilization is one of the earliest and most interesting of the world's ancient civilizations. Ancient Egypt was a civilization that is famous for its pharaohs, its mummies, and the different types of pyramids. Life in ancient Egypt began over 5,000 years ago, starting from around 3,100 BC till the death of its last ruler, Queen Cleopatra, in 30 BC. The Egypt is located in the eastern part of Sahara Desert in North Africa, as you can see in this map. It developed and flourished on the banks of River Nile. Except for the narrow strip of fertile land along the banks of the River Nile, rest of the Egypt was a desert, but this added an advantage because it protected Egypt from foreign invasions. These deserts were rich in the mineral deposits, including different types of metals that they used to make the simple tools. These tools they were using to shape huge blocks of limestone and granite into beautiful statues or pyramids. Nile was the key to the foundation and survival of the Egyptian civilization. The river was the source of life for Egypt. The annual flood deposit rich, black, fertile soil on the banks of the river that helps the farmers to grow the varieties of crops. The water from Nile was used for irrigation, and the river was used for transporting goods across the length and breadth of the country. Now we will discuss about the time periods of the different kingdoms. The Egyptian history has been divided into several periods known as the kingdoms. These periods represented stability in the Egyptian civilization. They were separated by the periods of instability called the intermediate periods. It has been divided into four parts: the early dynastic period, the old kingdom, the middle kingdom, and the new kingdom. In ancient Egypt, the king were known as the pharaohs, and they were holding the high post in the society. Now we will discuss about the society of the Egyptian civilization. The society has been divided into three classes. The upper class comprised of the pharaohs and the members of the royal family, and the priests and the high government officials. The middle class comprised merchants, manufacturers, artisans, and learned men. The lower class comprised small peasants, farmers, and laborers. And the slaves were the lowest level of the society. They were mostly the prisoners of the war. Now we will discuss about the family life. The ancient Egyptians placed a great deal of emphasis on family life and children. The members lived in a big joint family. The elderly persons were well respected, and the eldest male member, the father, was the head of the family. Women were respected and treated equally with men. Girls would learn housekeeping skills from their mothers, while the boys would follow in father's footsteps at the early age, either working in agriculture or learning about trade. Now we will discuss about the administration. The administration has been divided into four parts. First is the pharaoh, then officials, then provinces, and the public works. Pharaoh was the king. He was having all the power. He was the head of the state as well as the chief priest. Officials, the pharaoh was assisted by the officials who looked after the administration and collect taxes. Provinces, for the convenience of administration, the country was subdivided into provinces. Now the last one is the public work. Public works such as the construction of dams and canals were carried out by state. Irrigation was also the state's responsibility. In this way, we have seen that the administrative structure included all the four persons, the pharaoh, the number of officials and priests, and provinces and public works. And in overall, the pharaoh was on the top. So in this way, in this chapter, we have discussed about the location of Egyptian civilization, the features, why it is known as the Gift of Nile, the society structure, the family life, and the administration. That's all for today, students. We'll meet in the next class. Thank you.